Okay, good morning, cadets. Now, yes, let's study this notice writing and how the questions are going to appear in the examination on notice writing. Notice writing, it's a short composition, and on notice writing and classified advertisements, 3 marks questions will appear in the examination. So let us discuss the questions on notice writing. So at first, introduction of that. A notice is a written piece of information or news announcement. So what is a notice? It is announcement to be given to a particular group. It is a notice that is issued to a particular group so that they would come to know any particular event is going to take place in their organization. Since it is purely a formal information, its a language, tone and style should be formal and it should be to the point. Now, the points that to be remembered when you are writing the notice, when you are drafting the notice, follow the prescribed format. Use only passive voice as far as possible. Write short and simple sentences. It's quite easy for you because you will not be drafting this way, but you should know that, yes, how to draft that. So do not address anyone. Format name of the issuing authority. That is very much required on the top. Issuing authority. Notice has to be written in block letters, capital letters. Heading for subject of information. You were confused last time. What is heading? Whether notice is heading or, you know, the title that you will be writing, the heading that you will be writing. Date, details related to what, when and where without using I, name, designation. The entire notice has to be put in a box. Now let's go to these questions now. A notice can only be about a meeting or an event, excursion, all of this. So notice
all of these, sir.
All of these, yes, all of these are. So at the beginning we'll see those questions where the answers are also given there. So all of these, because a notice can be about a meeting, notice can be about event, it can be about excursion or trip or picnic, it can be on any of these, whichever are going to be there, maybe in the school or organization. So it will be related to that. So to inform for a meeting, yes, why it is all of this? Because to inform for a meeting, conduct an event like competition or excursion, etc. So in order to inform related to meeting or in order to conduct an event like competition or excursion. Okay, we'll move on to the next one. Which of these is the first thing to mention in a notice? Which of these is first thing to mention? So your name of the organization, notice, date, details. So here notice is meant for what? It is meant for few people, limited people, especially organization. So the first thing has to be name of the organization. So you know on the top usually you will write Sainik School Bijapur and then down you will write remaining one. Okay. Now, a notice may be issued only by the dash designated for the purpose. Peon, clerk, typist, officer. So here the officer, the head of the institution, especially an officer. So whoever is head, maybe, you know, in the case of a notice, not only that, it can be even, you know, class monitor or it can be school captain. It can be anybody who is heading that. But out of these four, the officer would be the right one. The content of notice must answer the questions. What, when, where, all of these. So the answer will be naturally D, all of these. Because what occasion, where it will be conducted, which place it will be conducted. So venue is very important. Yes. And when it is going to be conducted, that date is also very important. So when and where, these two are very, very important. And the purpose for which or what occasion it is. Yes, time, date and venue, all these are very important as far as content of notice is concerned, the matter of notice is concerned. Now, remember here, when you are writing the notice, notice should be written in first person, second person, third person, none of this. If you have got any doubt, you can ask. I hope it's quite clear to you. Notice has to be written in third person. Like first person is what I, me, we are, those are all forms of first person. Second person, you. But here, when you are drafting the notice, you are addressing the public. So therefore, it has to be written in third person. I hope it's quite clear to you. Like he, she, in case if you have to use that, then in that case, you have to use the third person. So third person information provided to the public. So whenever you are providing any information to the public, then in that case, you have to make use of third person. So one sample which is that we'll see here how it will appear there in the examination. So like these questions will be there. So while walking in a park in your neighborhood, you found a small plastic bag containing some documents and some cash. Complete this notice to be put on the park notice board, asking the owner to identify and collect it from you. So what has happened? They have found a small plastic bag. No, you were talking about lost and found. So here, a plastic bag is found which contains some documents, and here the notice has to be put on there in the notice board, asking the owner to identify the bag and he has to collect it from you. Okay, so let's go to that notice. So what will be the title of this notice? That you have to think about. What will be the title of the notice? And the title has to be appropriate. The title has to be appropriate. So the options will be given to you, but you have to find out the appropriate. And it will be very, very confusing to you also. So the date is given, so you need not worry about the date. But here you are concerned with what heading. Now here the name of the issuing authority is not given there. So there is no need, because here this one is lost and found. It is dealing with that. So therefore, here something is found there. So therefore, there is no need for you to write the name of the organization. It is you person, right? So this is to inform all the readers that dash in the dash, it has dash in it. So A, B, C, D will be given and you have to find out that. The plastic bag is red in color and is of medium size. It was found on September 1st at around 6 p.m. near the fountain in the park. The owner of the bag should contact me through phone number is given along with an identity proof. Thank you, Amit. Okay, choose the most appropriate option. So what will be the option there? Simple one, found, because here the bag is found. So out of these four, which is very easy, isn't it? So, and the past activity is mentioned here. So therefore, you know, whenever you are giving the title, you are giving the title in the past participle, you know, sometimes, or noun form of that, you'll be using that missing, found. So the most appropriate here it will be not missing, but found. She has found the bag. Yes, right. So, you know, lost and found, usually in the title, we write that lost or found. If it's a lost, yes, we write lost. If it's found, we have to write found, but not the plastic bag. Okay. Though it is ref, you may feel that all these, you know, all these three are correct. It is not the case. Only found is the most appropriate one. So that's why you have to be familiar with all this. So let's go to the next one now. Plastic bag is found. Plastic bag has been found. Plastic bag to find. Plastic bag is present. So remember here, when we are using that, we have to make use of present perfect tense. Immediately after finding it, with assurance, it is informed. So you have to make use of which tense? You have to make use of present perfect tense. So where we are using, you are using here, where there is a be. So I'll just... Okay, let's see here where we are using that. This I'm just trying to, if it can be reduced. Okay, I think it can be reduced, so no problem. So we'll just go and see here, yes, where B can be used. Right, this is to inform all the readers that The plastic bag has been found. See the tense that is being used here. That is what is very, very important. So you will be confused with all that. Okay. So now you'll come to which tense has to be used. Yes. Now here, where it is found? Ground, neighborhood park, neighborhood park, garden, road. So that's a park. So it, since it's a park, you should write park only. So since it's a park where many people in the neighborhood park. So, okay, you can't write as a garden. So park would be more appropriate where people visit that. Garden can be in front of your house. Okay. But park is a public place, public park, right? Okay. So you can say park there, the place where it was found. So next one is a mobile, some documents, few documents. So you already talked about that. There are few documents there and some cash. So materials found inside the bag, use of no other girl, followed by few documents and some cash, right? So few documents would be more appropriate rather than some documents, and some cash is also there. So that's why what all it contains. So you have to give rather than, you know, complete details of that, what all is there inside the bag. So what is there inside the bag? That is very important here. It was found on that and then near the founder. The own, see here, the details have been given their way on the top. So here, containing some documents and some cash. So it is given there. Cash is also there. But some documents, it will be not complete. So that's why few documents and some cash. So that will be more appropriate. I hope it's clear to you. Right. The last one, D1. Let's see here. D is also over. Okay, we'll move on to the next one now. Shall we see the next example? Yes. Okay. Yesterday during lunch break, you misplaced your notes on chemistry lectures. You want to get them back. So what has happened? You have misplaced your notes on chemistry lectures. Complete this notice for the school notice board. And who is writing that? You yourselves, you are writing that. So you are Tarun Atrapti, a student of class 12th KV or Kendriya Vidyalaya Raipur. Okay. So here on the top, Kendriya Vidyalaya Raipur, you can write Sainik School Bijapur. You can write the name of the organization, name of the institution on the top. Next will be notice, and A will be title or heading. So that will be the heading of the notice. Then what is B? See here, usually like these questions are appearing. B, yes, they have given that. You know, first sentence, this is to inform about what? That I have lost my dash in our school lawn area. The notes have a green cover. If anyone finds it, please return them to dash. So, Tarun Trapti, what is that? Undersigned, isn't it? Or simply drop them in the class 12th drop box. So, let's see here what should be the, I know, title or heading for this. So choose the most appropriate option here. So what will be the most appropriate here? Regarding chemistry lectures, displacement of chemistry notes, lost the chemistry notes. See here, lost the chemistry notes. You know, most appropriate whenever you are writing the title, how the title should be that a chemistry notes missing. It doesn't sound like a title. Lost the chemistry notes. That also doesn't like sound like a title. But, you know, in spoken language, you lost the chemistry notes, so you can use it. But the most appropriate out of all these is displacement of chemistry notes or chemistry notes missing. Now, regarding chemistry lectures, that will, you know, when you are, it's a subject and all there, you can make use of it. But here, chemistry lectures are not missing here. What are missing? They are notes. Okay. So regarding, you can use it only in the case of subject, but you shouldn't use it with title. The most appropriate will be displacement of chemistry notes. Okay, because it is dealing with chemistry notes. Okay, we'll move on to the second one. Now this is to inform what you or the whole staff or all students and staff, the kind of language you are using with. You see, you shouldn't use second person. So you ruled out. So you is ruled out because second person is there. I, first person, that is also ruled out. So here all students and staff, not the whole staff, all students and staff, because here you are addressing even the students. So the most appropriate will be here all students and staff. okay, all students and staff, to all the people who are there in the campus. So let's go to third. So this is to inform all students and staff. This is to inform all students and staff that I lost my dash. So what she has lost, let's see here. I lost my chemistry notebooks, chemistry booking during the lunch break, chemistry notes during the, so she, when she has lost during the lunch break, she has lost not notebooks, but she has lost notes. You have to be very, very particular about that. So what you have lost? You have not lost the notebooks, you have lost the notes. Chemistry books in school. So chemistry notes during lunch break. So material and possible location where it is lost. So here in C, in the case of C, let's see here, what is here? I have lost my chemistry notes during lunch break in our school lawn area. So where and when you are lost, right? That is also very important. The notes have a green cover. If anyone finds it, please return them to, or simply drop them. So return them to whom? Return them to the undersigned, or what is given there? Class monitor, 12th class head, monitor of 12th A, students of class 12th A. So monitor of 12th A, he's the most, I mean, is the responsible person, not class mentor, that he'll be giving you advice and all for your studies. 12th class head, that doesn't appear to be, you know, it doesn't sound correct. So monitor of 12th A, that is the most appropriate one. Okay. So we'll move on to the next one. If you have got any doubt, you can ask me. Or otherwise, we'll move on to the next sample. Sample 3. I think now you must have come to know that it is not so easy as it appears to be. Okay. MCQs. Now you are Amit or Anita, head boy or girl of your school. Write a notice for your school notice board requesting for entries from students for Britannia quiz contest to be held in your school, Kendriya Vidyalaya, Bilaspur. So Kendriya Vidyalaya, Bilaspur, then notice is given. Date is not appropriate here. It could have been on the left side. Date should have been there on the left side. So no worries, but anyway, now A is the heading there, or A is the title there. Now this is to inform. You know, what should be written, the students of class C here, what is given there, choose the most appropriate option there, contest for selection. So what is it? What is it now here? What you have to look what is given there in the question, what is given there in the question. Write a notice requesting for entries from students for Britannia quiz contest. So here, entry for Britannia quiz contest. So what is the title given here? Let's see here. Contest for selection, not right. Selection for quiz contest, inter-house selection or selections. The most appropriate, quite simple here, selection for quiz contest. It sounds, you know, it's a complete title. It sounds correct one. Okay, selection for quiz contest. So how the title should be written, probably you must have understood now. Okay, now we'll go to the B. Yes, boys, let's go to B now. Information, for information, to inform, and information. I think this is to inform. That is the, you know, that is the way we draft the notices. You know, in the case of letter writing, there's a particular way of starting the first sentence or starting the introductory paragraph. There's a particular way of drafting the notices. There's a particular way of drafting the formal letters. So here, this is to inform. To inform will come. Okay, so use of infinitive. Okay, let's move on to the next one now. See, those students, the student, a student, and that student. Now here, what is given there? Let's see here. This is to inform the students of classes 9 to 12 that the Britannia quiz contest is to be held on 21st September 2021. Only those students who had participated in the inter-house quiz contest. Okay, let's see D, what is given there, D. The options there in D. Student, 12th class, head, 12, a mentor are eligible. So they are eligible, verb and object, because already subject is given there and you are two. So who are eligible? So only those students who had participated in the inter-house quiz contest are eligible. So only those students can give their names. So interested students may give their names to the housemaster for selections on 28th August 2021. Amit Headball. Okay, we'll move on to the next now. We'll see this fourth example. Right. As a school captain of your school, write a notice for the school notice board informing the budding cricketers to attend trials for the selection of under 18 school team, Kendriya Vidyalaya Khairagad. Okay. So Kendriya Vidyalaya Khairagad. Right. Kendriya Vidyalaya Khairagad. Notice 23rd August 2021. So what should be the title? That is what is the question first in the case of this notice. So what is about that? So what will be the title? You have to just read the question first and try to understand the question. As a sports captain, you are writing a notice to inform what? The budding, you want to inform the budding cricketers what? To attend trials for the selection of. So here there is going to be selection, but you want them to, so trials for the selection of under 18 school team. Okay, so here, so most opportune, so cricket trials for under 18 school team, under 18 school team. So cricket trials for under 18 school team. So complete title is required here. Okay, then this is to inform to our cricket players that selection to school teams dash. So your selection to school teams now here will be made, was made, are none of this. So will be made would be future tense for organizing. The player, this player, that player, and the budding players. So the budding players, use of adjectives to emphasize. So what the budding players, upcoming players, all, yes, budding players who wish to be in the school team must attain the trials with complete cricket kits in all 20 players for each team purely on the basis of, so let's see here, purely on what? On the basis of, let's see here, because he's on the basis, okay, on the basis, that's right. Prepositional phrase which can define a verb. So on the basis of, so here, what is given here, let's see here. In all 20 players for each team, purely on the basis of the year's all-round performance. So they, in all 20 players for each team, purely on the basis of the year's all-round performance. Irfan Khan, sports captain. Okay, and now let's move on to the fifth one. After that, if you want to discuss, if you have got any doubts, we can discuss about those doubts. Okay, we'll see the fifth example, the last example we'll see, and then after that we can discuss about your doubts. If you have anything to say, yes. As a president of Resident Welfare Society, Dilshad Garden, New Delhi, write a notice requesting the residents not to use potable water for portable, P-O-T-A-B-L-E, it should be portable water for cleaning purpose. So drinking water for cleaning purpose. Resident Welfare Society, this address is not required, okay? Resident Welfare Society, right, New Delhi. That's enough. Dilshad Garden, probably not required there. Notice, and the date also can be written on the left. A. So A is the what should be the title there. So choose the most appropriate option. So the title, use water, strict use of water, use water judiciously, no water. So use water judiciously. Yes, you have to use water properly, judiciously. A title with complete information in a gist. So here we'll move on to the B question. What is it? Dash the acute shortage of water. So whether considering will come, what will come, let's see here. Referring, considering, none of this to consider. So considering use of gerund, which functions like a noun. So gerund functions like a noun. So keeping that in mind, considering the acute shortage of water in the colony, the residents are requested not to waste potable water. So no, yes, potable water. So they should not waste this drinking water by cleaning their cars, verandas, driveways, and for watering the plants with a hose pipe. A fine of rupees 500 C and D. Okay, a fine of rupees 500 C. What is it? will be imposed, yes, will be imposed will be a right one. Are imposed, was imposed, okay, will be imposed. So which tense you use, that is also very important. Gerund, you will be learning about the gerund is what? Actually, it's like a verb. So ing form will be there, but it will function like a noun. Like swimming is my, you know, playing cricket is my hobby, or swimming is my hobby. Yes, reading is my hobby. So you are making use of gerund there. So though it is a verb, it has, you know, it functions like a noun. It functions like a noun. Then we can call it as gerund. So what functions verb as well as noun, that is gerund, like reading, writing, swimming, considering. Okay, so let's go for the defaulters, by the default on the, okay. And so now let's see what is the question here. Right, a fine of rupees will be imposed on the defaulters. Kindly say water for a better tomorrow. So on the defaulters, president, yes, Dilshad Garden, New Delhi. So what is there? On the defaulters, that's most appropriate. That's object of a sentence. So we have seen five examples. We have seen five samples. At the beginning, we have discussed about this notice writing. And now, any doubt you have got, we'll discuss about that. Any doubt about that, we are going to take up that.